Hi everyone, thank you very much for joining this afternoon's webinar or this morning's webinar, depending on where you are in the world. While we're waiting for people to join, if you wouldn't mind just saying hi, popping where you are into the chat box, that would be great. Hi Liz, nice to see someone from the UK here. We're just waiting for people to join. So yeah, if you could just say hi, where you're from in the chat, that'd be fantastic. Hi Huda. Hello, Percy in Peru, and Brian from Colombia, and Marcia from Mexico. Looks like we've got a big Latin American contingent here today. Hola. So we're just going to wait for more people to join the session. So if you don't mind bearing with. So we'll probably give it another minute. So say hi, where you're from in the chat box. I'll just give it another 30 seconds. Well, thank you very much for joining today's session. It's wonderful to see so many of you here, and it's great to see people from all over the world joining. It seems like a big contingent from the Middle East and South Latin America. Okay, I'll get started. Hi, I'm Justin from Cambridge and I'll be your host for today's webinar. In today's session, I'm going to explain why to you and your organization that you should recognize Cambridge English exams. But before I start, a little bit of housekeeping. I'm going to share a few suggestions to help you enjoy the session. If you've got a couple of moments, please close all other programs in your on your laptop or computer. If you can, this will help with your connection. Sometimes during the session, there may be a delay. Don't worry if this happens, please just bear with us. This is because it's potentially a live, this session is a live session, and it is being recorded and the recording will be shared afterwards. During the webinar, you'll be able to use the chat box for any comments and the separate Q&A box for any questions for me to answer. If you have a short answer to your question, our moderators will type in an answer straight away and may share useful links. I will try and answer as many questions as I can at the end, so don't worry if your question isn't answered straight away. I would like to start by saying Cambridge English is part of the university, Cambridge University Press and Assessment, which is a non-teaching department of the University of Cambridge. The university's reputation for outstanding academic achievement is known worldwide and reflects the intellectual achievement of its students, as well as a world-class original research carried out by the staff of the university. Our research focuses on understanding the way people learn and speak English and how best to assess them. This extends the university's research capability in the field of English language. Our activities contribute to the achievement of the university's mission to contribute to society through the pursuit of education, learning, and research at the highest international levels of excellence. So who are we? As part of the university, we have an educational ethos and a strong duty to ensure that our assessments have a positive impact on education. We provide the world's leading range of qualifications and tests for learners and teachers of English. And we help millions of people every year learn English, improve their skills to the world. So here are a few facts and figures on Cambridge English for you. Over 65 million exams and tests have been taken to date. We have 2,800 exam centres in 130 countries. We support over 1 million digital learners each day. 5.5 million qualifications and tests are taken every year. We're accepted by 25,000 organisations worldwide. And there are over 50,000 preparation schools globally. As you can see, these are all big numbers, but let's focus on the number of organisations worldwide that accept our qualifications and tests. Our qualifications and tests, as I mentioned earlier, are recognised by over 25,000 organisations and open the door to exciting higher education and employment opportunities. They're accepted and trusted by 13,000 higher education and further education institutions, more than 11,000 employers, and over 750 governments and ministries. You can find their details of the organisations that accept our exams via our global online database, which can be found on our website, and I believe there's a link in the chat. Many of our qualifications and tests are also accepted for visa and study purposes in the UK, Ireland, Australia, USA, and Canada. Our exams are globally accepted by universities around the world for higher education, including the destination markets. This is just a selection. B2 First, C1 Advanced, and CT Proficiency are the exams commonly accepted for this purpose. And you'll be able to find the full list on our global online recognition database. Our exams and tests are widely accepted and used by companies for recruitment and training development and promotion purposes. A large number of our candidates use our exams to prove their English ability for employment. They want to get the best jobs with the best companies in the world. We have recognition with some of the biggest brands in the world. Aligning our name with these successful brands reinforces to candidates the vast number of opportunities they have when taking one of our exams. It really is a powerful message. In addition to companies, many ministries of education around the world specify our qualifications and tests in their English language requirement for school or university leavers or for teacher recruitment. They're also accepted by government bodies for visa purposes. For example, the Department of Home Affairs or Doha in Australia, Immigration New Zealand, and the Irish Naturalisation and Immigration Services in Ireland. So I'm going to focus on three of our qualifications. And the reason why I would like to focus on these three is because they're the ones we would recommend for admissions to colleges and universities, depending on the programme and level of study, and as proof of English language proficiency for the workplace. B2 First is an upper intermediate exam focused at the B2 level of the CFR. A B2 First qualification proves the applicant has the language skills to live and work independently in an English-speaking country or study on courses taught in English. Many universities and colleges use B2 First for foundation, ESL programs, or pre-sessional courses or college admission. This exam equates roughly to an IELTS 5 or an IELTS 6. So on to C1 Advanced. More than 10,000 educational institutions, businesses, and government departments around the world accept C1 Advanced as proof of high-level achievement in learning English. Preparing for C1 Advanced helps learners develop the skills to make most of studying, working, and living in English-speaking countries. It is the perfect level of English to succeed at undergraduate and graduate level courses. It is focused at the C1 level of the CFR, which is around 6.5 of IELTS or an 8 in IELTS and tests academic English skills. C2 proficiency is a qualification which shows the world the applicant has mastered English to an exceptional level. It proves they can communicate with the fluency and sophistication of a highly competent English speaker. Preparing for and passing the exam means they have a level of English that's needed to study or work in a very senior professional or academic environment, for example, on a postgraduate or PhD program. This is our highest level of English qualification. The exam is focused at the C2 level of the CFR, which is an IELTS 8 or higher. B2 First, C1 Advanced and C2 Proficiency are level-based exams. This is because the exams are in-depth assessments focused on a particular level rather than thermometer tests covering the full range of levels. They provide a more reliable indicator of a student or applicant's language skills. This reduces the risk that the student's English does not match expectations and can help you make your admissions decisions for your different courses or for job roles and employment. They are curriculum-based exams, and the majority of students undertake a language improvement course rather than test preparation course to focus on developing their language skills and improving their level of English. So what's in the exams? Here are a few key points. Each exam tests reading, writing, and speaking, which is always face-to-face, listening, and also use of English, grammar, and vocabulary. They are designed to be fair to all students, regardless of their language, gender, or ethnicity, and they support all the major varieties of English. They're available at our global test center network, which we have 2,800 test centers in 130 countries, and students can take paper-based or computer-based versions. And they are taken by hundreds of thousands of candidates each year. If we focus on C1 Advanced, this slide shows the individual components and timings of the exam. This slide shows the typical abilities of a candidate at the CFR level C1. The applicant can follow an academic course at university level, communicate effectively at managerial and professional level, deal confidently with living in an English-speaking environment, participate effectively in meetings or academic tutorials and seminars, carry out complex and challenging research, express themselves with a high level of fluency, and react appropriately in different cultural and social situations. So that's what's in an exam. Now on to security. All of our test materials are developed securely in Cambridge with questions stored in a secure item banking system. When it comes to the production of the actual test papers, this is done within our own printing facility in our high security warehouse in Cambridge. All our test centres have to meet with our regulations for the secure storage of test materials and the administration of the tests. We check every test centre before approving them to make sure they have the correct facilities. Another important aspect is test day photos. We take test day photos of candidates as an additional measure to help you check that the person applying to your institution is the same person who took the test. There is centralised marking. So this means no marking takes place at test centres. The exam papers are anonymised and assigned to markers at random to ensure there is no conflict of interest between the examiners and the candidates. Once marking has taken place, we run some statistical checks to see if there are any unusual patterns in the results of individual students or groups of students. This allows us to detect any attempted malpractice before the results are released. And then finally, our online results verification service provides the final layer of security in allowing you to check a student's results directly against our central records and the test day photo. We will look at this service a bit later on in the session. So on to the reporting of results. So far, we've seen what's in the test and how it's delivered. And now I'm going to briefly cover results and scores. B2 First, C1 Advanced, and C2 Proficiency all report to the Cambridge English Scale. And this is a single range of scores used to report results from multiple Cambridge English exams and tests. You can see the scale score on the slide on the right, on the slide now. And that's the one highlighted in the box that's just come up. I will talk more about the Cambridge English Scale and score setting for your institution in our next webinar, which is taking place on Tuesday. So please do sign up for that. Candidates receive a statement of results showing their overall score and their individual scores for each skill, as shown on the next slide. So here is the statement of the results. It shows a candidate's overall score, the CFR level, and the individual component scores for all skills. This is used for admissions teams in higher education if you set minimum requirements per skill. And lastly, to help you set the right scores for admissions, we have mapped the Cambridge English scale to the IELTS scale. For example, if you require an IELTS 6.5 for direct admission, you would ask for 176 on the Cambridge English scale. As I said, I will go into more detail about the Cambridge English Scale and score setting next week, so please do sign up for the session. So that is Cambridge English Qualifications. Remember to post your questions, if you have any, in the chat box as we go. We would encourage you to register for the results verification service. This is a free online tool to help you verify that the candidate applying to your institution is a genuine candidate by checking their results and their identity with our systems. Here's a layout of the service. You can quickly see how many new candidates you have to verify at the top of the page. These will appear in bold in the list below. The service offers you the ability to refine your search. You can search for candidates by name, date of birth, ID number, exam taken, the place the exam was sat, the exam centre, the candidate's email address, the date of the exams. All candidates shares are listed at the bottom of the page. And you can click the view button to see more details about the individual candidate. Here is an example of the information you will see for each candidate to help verify their scores. We also have a webinar at the end of March talking about the results verification service in more depth, and this will be the final webinar of this series. So now I'd like to say talk about how you can accept Cambridge to support and reach more applicants, be it for work or study. The three exams, B2 First, C1 Advanced, and C2 Proficiency, have been taken by hundreds of thousands of students from around the world, from more than 100 different countries. Cambridge English Qualifications are the exams you can trust. They're backed up by research, meaning our exams are based on research, and the research says how important real life, real world conversation is. So we've designed the exams so learners can use their skills for everyday life, work, study, and travel. They are designed to be fair to all users, all nationalities and backgrounds, with questions going through a trial period to make sure they're fit for purpose. Our exams are securely delivered. In the previous slides, I mentioned the numerous ways we ensure our exams are safely and securely delivered, from authorized test centers, test day photos, through to centralized marking. These things will give you confidence in the reliability of the results that we release. And as previously mentioned, they're accepted by over 25,000 organisations. And there's no better proof than hearing other people's experiences. And so I can tell you that's 25,000 organisations from higher education, ministries of education, and employers trust our exams. So Cambridge English Qualifications are exams you can trust. Combining all of those things means you can have the confidence that the applicants will have the right English skills to succeed. Our exams are rigorous exams testing all four skills. We test students in a way that helps them build practical, real-life communication skills. Our qualifications are easily mapped to other tests, you know, to help ensure consistency throughout your English language requirements, whatever is needed for your academic programs or job roles. So there are a few key reasons why you should accept Cambridge English qualifications. So how would you recognize our exams as an organization? Well, the first step is easy. Simply tell us you accept our exams and we will add you to our online database and our public website. The site gets thousands of hits every week and is a great place to showcase your institution. Typically, what happens is our students search this database to see which institutions accept their certificates and scores, and then they make contact. The second way is to publish the acceptance on your own website. From experience, most of you will have a dedicated page on your website or even on job adverts detailing the English language requirements you require. We would encourage you to publish our exams and required scores on this page or job advert alongside other tests. Remember to use the ARPS comparison chart if needed. And then let us know once you've published so we can use this link on our online database and then we can use the two in tandem. And here is an example from a UK HEI displaying their requirements for detailing the Cambridge English score. Lastly, we want to work with you to help reach these students and candidates. There are a number of promotional activities we run free of charge. I've listed a few on this slide, but the easiest and quickest win for you to do is share things like your company logo, photos, testimonials, so we can share them on our social media pages. We have the largest educational Facebook page in the world with almost 6 million fans. So sharing content via us is sure to reach lots of people. The Cambridge English Twitter account has over 128,000 followers. Our Cambridge English TV channel on YouTube has over 712,000 subscribers and has had nearly 40 million channel views. And our Instagram page has nearly 500,000 followers and helps learners to be inspired, learn together and celebrate success. If you would like to talk about more about some of these ideas, please get in touch. Here is an example of an institution just doing that. So this is California State University in Long Beach, and they're showing, and we're collaborating, showing that they recognize our exams, and we're using our social sites to promote this fact. That's the end of the webinar. I'd just like to say that our next one is on Tuesday, where I'll be going more in depth about the Cambridge scale and score setting for your institution. And then on March the 31st, I'll be talking about our secure verification service. And it's not just me here at Cambridge and the recognition team. Our recognition team covers the globe. I'm only responsible for the UK, Ireland, Netherlands and the Nordics. Mario and Hisham here on the top row look after Europe, Middle East and Africa. Ken and Carmen, the bottom left, are responsible for recognition in Asia, China, Australia and New Zealand. Our country manager, Pete, covers the US and Canada. And Hazel is your contact for Latin America. So if you have any specific recognition questions or you want a more in-depth discussion with regard to your organization or institution, please contact us at recognition@cambridgeenglish.org and one of the team will reach out and get in touch. So that's the end of the session. So does anyone have any questions? And Bev's going to share any questions that there are.
Hi, Justin. Yeah, we've just to say as well that if anybody wants to their organisation to recognise our exams and they haven't done already, then I've put in the chat two recognition forms people can fill out depending on what organisation, type of organisation they come from. So that's there if you want to recognise our exams.
That's great. Thank you, Bev.
There's a question from Brian who says, I would like you to talk about kids tests, starters, movers and flyers. Thank you.
Unfortunately, I'm not an expert on those. I talk about examinations that are useful for higher education or the world of work. Brian, if you could contact the recognition email address after the session, we can put you in touch with the right person. There's a wealth of information on our YouTube pages, cambridgeenglish.org, the website. So, yeah, but please get in touch and we'll point you in the right direction.
Okay, we've got a couple of other questions. So how do I recognise Cambridge qualifications and tests?
That's an excellent question, Bev. And I believe you've just mentioned that you've posted the recognition forms in the chat. There's two different ones. What's the difference between the two, Bev?
Okay, so there's one for higher education institutions and another one for companies. We also do have a generic form. So if you don't think that those forms suit your organisation and your requirements, then let us know and we can forward you a generic recognition form as well.
That's fantastic. Thank you, Bev.
And another question, how many exam centres do you have?
We have over 2,800 and I believe they're in more than 130 countries worldwide. So there's plenty of opportunity for students to take our qualifications and tests. And the great thing about our qualifications and tests is lots of candidates are taking them as part of their school year, so they don't need to take an additional test to for higher education.
Thank you. And Samar has asked, do you provide Delta and is it equivalent to MA TESOL?
We are the organisation that runs Delta, but I can't tell you whether it's equivalent to an MA TESOL. I'm not an expert in teaching awards, unfortunately. But once again, Samar, if you can write to me at the recognition at cambridgeenglish.org mailbox, we'll get back to you and point you in the right direction.
I think also there is on the Ofqual website, which the UK provide, there is an equivalency search engine there where you can see the equivalent exams, so that might be helpful as well.
Okay, that's great. We'll pop, so if you email us, we'll send you that link, Samar, because I know the Ofqual site's quite tricky to navigate.
Okay, Samar says thank you for that response.
My pleasure.
And how do I compare Cambridge English qualifications to IELTS?
Well, that's a great question, whoever's asked that. I think, Bev, you posted a link to a document within...
I will do that now.
...the chat. So please refer to that. It uses the Cambridge English scale to help us map the equivalences. But if you want to know... please sign up to the webinar, basically, which is going to be taking place on Tuesday. And then we'll be talking about that in depth.
That's all the questions for now, Justine, unless anybody else has got anything to add to the Q&A section.
Well, I'd like to think that's because I've covered everything in the session, which is fantastic. Thank you very much for joining us. I hope everyone found the session useful. Please do fill in the feedback forms, which will be sent at the end of the event, and please do sign up for the session on Tuesday and then the 31st of March about the verification service. Thanks all for...
Justin, I have found another question. What's the difference between a prep centre and becoming a recognition institution? That's from Marcia.
Okay, Marcia, a prep centre is a school that prepares students, candidates for our examinations. A recognising organisation is someone that uses our exams as proof of English language proficiency, for admissions onto university courses, as proof of English for the workplace. So hopefully that's answered your question.
And I've got a couple more, sorry, I've missed these, were in the chat. Diana Says, good morning, my name is Diana Mendez from Colombia. In our school, students already present Cambridge exams, flyers and preliminary. Do we need to get that recognition, or how do I know if we already have it?
First of all, look at our online database for your school to see if it's there. If it's not, Marcia, please write to us at recognition@cambridgeenglish.org and we'll get back to you.
Okay, and one final question from Dr. Ibrahim. What is the update about lingual skill recognition?
Lingual skill is an institutional test. I know there's... So organisations and companies can use it for proof of English language proficiency. So it's down to the individual institution. We don't recommend it for admissions purposes, but you can be used as an institutional test for course placement, exit, promotion in work, etc., etc. I kind of think if that's the last question, I think that's the end of the webinar. Yeah. Okay, yeah, once again, thanks for attending, and hopefully see you all on Tuesday. Thanks all.